That shit to fuck me up. That shit to fuck me up, right? She didn't even wear it now.
Which one, Kelly?
Not long. Wally. I got far.
More apa, you don't shall let
I do. Bro, I said. More connect, more full. What's your law?
Along. It will not jet. You don't love.
Fruits near, I mean.
Fruit, eh? Fruit not that.
Mm. Yeah, so. Well, we talk about something that you see, like rap as we did.
Yeah.
Mm. It's too different from the one who they see, maybe say, even people who want travel, go greener pasture. Mm. If we not accept,
yeah.
Accept ourselves proper, the madness
yeah.
They go meet for them, I say, still black oppression, you feel me?
Yeah.
And the importance of that kind, the kind vibe, what we're supposed to get. Maybe say, no matter what the beef is, no matter what the madness is, it's also on the level of, like, guy, we know, say,
Belly.
So I feel like we get that kind of matter, so people understand that beyond just the lyricism that they hear, there's also intellect that is very African, where that's very us.
Yeah.
That's why I call it returning to our souls, because I like Ikunye Shenoni Bere.
Benio.
Mm-hmm.
Hold on,
no matter
how you guys hold on, live. You guys stay in your living room. I don't want movement here. Stay in your living room. I'm on live, please. Most of my please in my head. The room, the beach. Thank you. Stay in the living room. I don't want movement here. Stay in your living room, please. Thanks. Bye. Yeah, my Binu Dari Baba. Come on,
no, no matter. It doesn't mean Larry Day, you don't call.
Yeah, so or this hip hop thingy rap, where are we starting from? Is it yeah, obviously mostly liberal, you know? Let me start from I think the Nigerian rap fans.
Mm.
There is a lot that they don't understand. You get, and it has negatively, you know, affected the Kilongwe. It's not the culture; it's the genre, I think. Because first off, I didn't have to realize the beginning Kilongwe. Can you read my poetry, Abi?
Yeah,
I don't know what we're going to. You get.
Mm-hmm.
So, and I believe. Oh, I have always believed that, you know, it should be done. Music in the first place, or any art, is the main purpose of your own shenko. I mean, the guy, if you are trying to exhibit your art, you understand, or you're trying to display art or whatever, you know, your primary objective is that the audience, or no, this is empty. Check the first one. The first one. This is empty. You get
primary.
You understand? So your primary objective is that, you know, you reach, you know, as large an audience as you can.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? That's the primary objective to everybody. You understand? If you're selling a product, your primary objective is to, you know, reach, you understand, maximum potential, reach the maximum audience you can, you know, maximize your potentials, you know, as much as you can. And I think, of course, language will always be a factor here, down here. You understand? Language will always be a factor because we come from a club in Nigeria, you know, multi clinical. You know, you understand?
Yeah,
many languages you get. So, there is this ideology or this idea that people that, you know, rap in English are superior to people who rap in their native tongues or languages and all that, and I think it's a bullshit. First off, bullshit idea. Me talk about no, I'm not doing anymore. I found like yeah, really. Idea sharing. I'm sorry for that. Idea. You understand? So,
yeah.
Because the primary objective, like I said, is to reach in your pupil. You get not so many people have you know, are going to be as fortunate as yourself or as M or Zamani. You understand? As Sinzu or as a few others. You understand? Who rap in English. Of course, you can do both. You can do anyone you choose for. You understand? I'm talking primarily. Not so many people will be that fortunate. You understand? Because even that type of rap, there's a lot that comes with it. The acceptance, the level of education. You understand? Now, the audience, you understand what I'm saying? So, you know, all of us cannot. You understand? So, some people have to do this thing to get accepted. And I've always said this, that I don't respect the art and not the language. You understand? Respect the art and not the language. Yes, I don't speak Igbo, and there are guys that I've seen that Philo has, you know, shared with me a couple times that he has posted, and you know, this guy is dope. There was a guy I sent to him. There was a guy that did my this Samsung freestyle I did then. He signed the boy now. The boy is signed to Philo right now. You understand? Yeah, he discovered him. You know, discovered him on my page. You know, and I just knew this kid was dope, and I posted it. I didn't understand him. You know, not a word of what he said. But I just knew. You just, you know, you sense, you know the art, you know the armor, you get so, and that's what hip-hop is about. Hip-hop is about, you know, people you're trying to, hip-hop is, you know, hip-hop is, no other genre can boast of making conscious music as much as, you know, hip-hop, rap.
Yeah.
Rappers are the most, you know, conscious of the, you know, the entire group. So, if you're trying to reach out to people, if I'm trying to pass a message across to people and, you know, I'm reaching, say, max 10%, 12%, I don't think I'm doing a great job. Emil, I'm speaking, you know, for myself. I don't think I'm doing a great job. So I'd rather go for, you know, language that would make me reach 60, 70, 80, 75%. And, oh, yeah. And while doing that, well, of course, one in Olobe Loloko, Elero Lolo, you understand? I'm, you know, pushing on Wally, leg back home, because money is very important, you know. You look around you look at your society, you look at how people measure success, and you know what it all boils down to at the end of the day. You understand? Which is what I think we at this level, when I say we at this level, I mean those of us that have been around for say a decade, you know, or a little less than a decade, or over a decade, we should try, you know, to put it into the heads of the younger ones or the young cats out there trying to do stuff, that look, in as much as, you know, it is important to display your art, your dope, your, you know, a couple of fans here and there want to gas you up and tell you, oh, you're keeping it real, you're not dumping down, you're not, you're a purist. That's all these attempts. You get so, you know, and you want to satisfy them. You must also remember that, you know, music is a business, and these songs you are putting out have to be treated like products. You understand? They have to be treated like product. Because you should ask yourself, if it weren't music you're putting out, if I was selling, if I'm trying to sell this headphone now, you understand? How would I market it? Would I try to sell as much as I can? Or would I just say, oh, I'm selling to limited people? You understand? So these are questions.
As much as you can to make someone
now. You understand? The younger ones. So, I'm just talking about the how the Nigerian average Nigerian hip hop fan, you know, wants to consume their music, and you know, wants you to remain a certain way and not, you know, sound a certain way and not, you know, of which Kopo. But yeah, Babami, Kopo, it's not possible.
I appreciate you for that. For that to me, yeah, because in my head, most times when I try to relate with the young ones, my conversation are mostly on some say, understand what whoever is investing in is investing in first.
Yeah.
Now, different case, say, you get audience, everything they pop.
Yeah.
Get interest, come invest in what you can do with it. So,
yeah.
It's a different ballgame that they're bringing you into the market.
Yeah.
And they're introducing you into the market. So everything is being built from the scratch.
Yeah.
However, be honest with yourself enough to accept what you did willing to do. So if you're willing to blow, if you're willing to, bro, don't worry yourself. When I did right, it is my time. Kidimo, we as Vector Divine, we be beyond the TOP, we are the PC of Go, we be mobile at the Gaga, so promotion time. Man. Excuse me. I didn't feel the need to go in bar for bar, because in my head, if at all, I am introducing the cultural and native music people into my hip hop. Like, I'd introduce my Lafayette people, I'd introduce people, if you say, maybe they don't know NWA, they don't know all these guys, I'll come over here to Pac and BBG. Right? Yeah. I know, say, I'd introduce them to the art of rap. So, now, gradual, bar. So,
yeah.
If I did piece you up, go, we will, madam. Oshé, Oshé. Also, if you let to join, you know, you don't travel plenty things for the same Nigeria. I'm all you have to tell us, I'm all you have to tell us,
yeah.
So, when you're making your music, it should be okay to apply the mentality of everything that has been your reality so far as well.
Of course, because this is our reality. I tell people now, okay, listen, you're making a rap song, you're trying to make a gangster rap song or rap lyric. Go, yeah, listen. Ni Nigeria, ko si Bobby Boy wa Yankee, ibo ko ti ti dodo wa bae. So yes, so ni si, ko so wo bo. So ni si, you fetch lyrics, go be form gangster lyrics. You understand? You want to do hey bye. You want to do gangster lyrics. O wa soro bo. I don't know if you get what I'm saying. O soro moto, town you really. You understand? A car that your audience do not even no exists, like they don't even, you know, you'd have to, oh yeah, they'd have to, someone has to explain to them that they have to Google to understand what, you know, what that car is, or you understand. So you need to make it as relatable as you can. You understand? Nobody's forcing you, but just make it as relatable as you can, because at the end of the day you just want to win more people over and, you know, expose yourself, expose your art, exhibit your art to, you know, as many people as you can and win them over. You know, it's not, we are not in America, bro. You understand? I repeat this every time. We are not in America. You understand? We are not in America. So an average American cannot relate to a Niger gangster rap song. Cannot relate. Even if they translate for him. He not feel relate, because all the things will be the talk here. You understand? Not be in your own reality for New York or for, you understand? Take me back to America. Talk to America, she need milk to mamu. So yeah, talk America, she need milk. Only see that to mamu. You are okay. So yeah, but to my baby, baby, you get what I'm watching. Bolo, talk to America, I'm watching. Bolo, I'm buying. So yeah, mamu milk. You know? So you're crazy. So I just chose to. I prefer to speak my own. You know, my own reality and talk about what I'm, you know, what I'm familiar with, what I know, and what people that listen to me understand. I don't need to translate nothing. Once you listen, you know that, oh, but again, so I call 40 sitawa. Oh yeah, I call by 40 sita, which is, you understand, it's easy, you understand when I say I want my call by 40 sita. You understand what I'm saying already. So I think, yeah, so I think a lot of these cats, the young ones, you should take your machine on, you know, we just need to let them know, look, yeah, I understand you can rap, I understand. You know, who influenced your music and whatever, but you need to create you out of, you know, all these influences you have had over the years. Of course, everybody was influenced by someone. Of course, I'm not going to sit down here and say I wasn't influenced by American rappers. Of course, I'm not going to do that. You know, so everybody was influenced. Well, of course, you pick a little here and there, and, you know, you put your own, you inject your own reminisce in it. And that's what made reminisce, that's what made Vec. You understand?
Yeah.
Vec listened to a lot of Yankee rappers and whatever, and, you know, other Pilari, you know, and that's Vector. You understand? That's how you create your own sound, your own reality, and whatever, you know. Because this thing, the man saw Kiniko and Tech 449. Oh, my, my brother, they're 44. Need to tell my army.
Oh, Kalu, you
Joe, yeah.
Well, I appreciate the fact that we align this matter, because give or take, some, for example, boys with the Edo, Bini, Widaway, only beat in Washington, Shelly. Those of us who go for barrack, you get that happening for us.
And
the ultimate goal, based on what Africa is supposed to be about, where we don't say it's supposed to be bagbe beef, bagbe bobo, who is right and who's wrong, and I say we have to find a way to accommodate every level of greatness possible.
Yes.
So if reminisce is on, I tell you before, and I say, Allah, you don't worry yourself, I believe you when you're young. I told you before. It's worthy enough for me to be in America and be like, ah, okay, I hear your gangster school. But if you come to Lafayette, that's my budget, you're like guy. Now different way. So my boo tamak. That's so now, like, and because and it's also okay for somebody in the hood to grow up to be able to get to a level where only bang for polota, king or not only the allowed to go.
Yeah.
Because because greatness affect great, no. That but she start to go, then what is the idea?
What is at the end of the day, At the end of the day, wasted effort. You know. Wasted effort.
Yes, sir. But I appreciate you for doing this, because at the end of the day, plenty made a full basket. And we're talking about our full beat now.
I was going to ask you a question before we got to that level. Like, what is your take? Like, this question, missing not verbally, will definitely rap for Brits is going to come in there. Like, what's your take on what influence do you think Nigerian rappers have or will have on Afrobeats?
You know, say knowledge, you know, the day until somebody go discover and come show us, say, no knowledge, or we discover ourselves.
Yeah,
I have taken it upon myself to look at, okay, why am I so gifted at this with rap? So I don't trace them now. Say, okay, am I sure we know by him? If you check out, maybe Gugas be poetry. Once you have a foundation, like a foundational thought of such, say, in your ancestry, say something similar to rhythm and poetry day, because now we get rhythm. And poetry, now we did drum set, right? Once you establish that kind of matter, you will now be able to freely look at rap and adapt rap in any, from you, adapting rap in any other way doable, because as much as we are the hybrid Africans, say now we then born in the internet era, but now we see the last analog set into the digital, right?
Meaning, very correct. Very correct.
Meaning it must be okay for me to be, I don't give a damn what you say about me. Can be tired, my nigga ran me. I can be that because that is me. I feel like our rap needs to get to that point. So, what does Oja mean here? That's dope, bro. Yeah,
because I think, I think everybody's kicking out, everybody's cashing out, because this is my understanding, or let me say my understanding of, I think it is Afrobeats as a genre, then I think it has sub-genres like, say, Auteur, there's the Auteur side of it, there's the pop side of it, you understand? Then there is R5, which is, you know, the rap side. Of it, and I think the other guys are really, really pushing hard. The other guys are doing good. They're collaborating. They are pushing forward, and I think what I see on our side is not really nothing to write them about, because it's it's one person fighting another, one person trying to do negative stuff for attention, for one day trend, 2 days trend. You know, people not putting the younger ones, you know, into the right, you know, telling them the right things to do. Because whether we like it or not, a bunch of the most influential, you know, people in this genre right now, close to 40 than they are to 30. That's a fact. You understand? That's a fact. Whether we like it or not, the biggest rappers in this country are closer to 40 than they are to 30. You understand? Yeah. Except for a few. You understand? So I mean, right now people should be at a stage where you are handing down knowledge to the next gen. You understand? Yeah. Telling them what works, being sincere to them, telling them what works and what will not work. Because you have been there, you don't get experience. You sabi, you know what will work and what will not work. I think a lot of people have been hypocrites, misleading the kids, you know, telling them this, that, so that maybe they don't end up being as great as they are, or so they cannot be equal. Because I think some people want to die with the greatest and the dance, you know, which has never been my problem and will never be. Which has never been my problem and will never be. You know, I am a result driven human being. You know, I believe whatever I've done is Okwan Ogirilemimbi, by the way. I just put it up there for my kids to see. So, you know, so I'm not bothered by that. And because, like you mentioned earlier, all these things we are doing, a bunch of us, you know, the biggest amongst us are closer to 40 than 30. And, you know, you question yourself, so what have you done? What have you achieved if you can't hand, you know, down knowledge to the younger ones and tell them the truth that this is how it works. Look, this is how you're going to do it. We understand you do this, but this is how, you understand, you're going to do it and, you know, you become this way. You understand? But rather than that, a lot of people, I think, mislead these kids. And, you know, that's why our part of, you know, this thing, now why they last, now we they suffer pass. You understand? Now we they struggle. Now we they struggle get streams. Now we they struggle get attention. Now why we guys do something? Fight each other before we release.
Ma play. Ma play devil's advocate. Make a play devil's advocate. I don't know who they raise plenty youngins. But I don't know what the mental stamina threshold is for them. But it'd be like say. You see that patience and way that they tell us since when we serve the youngins, so we'll be picking for us. Maybe I see that I barely experienced that. Like you're doing your best to make stuff pop, right? Yeah. But still the same legacy that you're trying to run, it'd be like say you have to prove yourself so much to show something that is so right to do.
Yes.
Like you know it I talk like we youngins are coming up because we also need to address the view of the men that are leading or the followers that are following.
Yeah.
We just let them know because at the same time a human being everybody be, you feel me, bro?
Yeah. Yeah.
I know they put paper with plenty of people, but I do my best, same you've mentioned earlier.
Yeah, of course. I know you've done yours. I've done mine. I know a lot of people doing, you know, their own beat as well. And I think that boils down to, you know, earlier today, I saw someone, I think someone posted something about how young, I think it was Ilbliss. Ilbliss posted something, I think, yesterday or 2 days ago. Someone shared with me. He was telling youngins that, sit down there, don't hustle, and continue accusing me, Fino and Zoro, of not signing you, of not helping you. That sit down there, don't hustle, eh? You know, so it just reminded me so much of, you know, I think we had this discussion last week about how much entitlement is, you know, down there. You know, how people think, oh, you're entitled to this, or once this person signs you, attaches you, or gives you a little bit of affiliation, so you must succeed or you must blow, and, you know, then this sudden disregard for how much impute or how much, you know, that person invested in you financially and, you know, mentally suddenly disappears into thin air because you don't have the results, you know, you had hoped for. And, you know, like you mentioned something as well here that, you know, in as much as we want to address the men who lead, we need to address those who follow as well. I think a lot of them don't come with the right attitude. I'm not into names. I don't like mentioning names. I'm not into names, but bro, I'll be very honest. Black Bones is, I like the kid.
Yeah.
The kid has everything it takes to be a superstar. He has everything. Yeah. The kid Sabi, puts himself in a position saying, yo, I know you're not streaming this thing. You need to stream it. This shit is go and do it.
You understand? That
requires a lot of humility, bro. You understand?
Of course.
He's telling you, oh, I know I'm not, so go and do it. You understand? And he's doing it in a way that you like. There's no arrogance involved. Playful. He's doing thing. He's a dope rapper. He's talented.
Yeah.
You understand? He's funny. He's the total package. Like I call him the new Fouls. Like the boy in a complete package. You understand? The boy in a complete package. He can rap. He can sing. He's funny. You understand? And he dey push. Regardless of who him dey with or who sign him, he dey push. He push every day. That's the key. Push. You understand?
Very my boss said this thing. A lot of people see black moving online, and they have a lot of things that they have as opinions of him, especially with that old beef matter. But catch the vibe. No broadcast with black send. Why don't they receive? Like, no worry yourself. Whilst you may think out there that maybe somewhere, Baba, don't worry yourself. Today, let me say, now say they go right.
He has the right attitude already. You understand? He's not entitled. He doesn't think because he's signed or affiliated to this person, so he's not getting the right. You understand? He has told himself, from what I think I have seen about the kid, I think he has told himself, look, it is my responsibility regardless of who I'm with. So I need to take charge.
You have to know your problem first.
You understand? So I respect that. I respect the kid. You understand? I respect the kid. I respect that. Yeah. Like, nobody's going to take that away from him. He's talented. He can rap. nobody's doubting that you can sing, but so can a lot of people.
Yeah.
You understand? So can a lot of people. So what separates him from them is the will to push and take responsibility for. I mean, so yeah, he's a great kid. So I'm going to single him out from the bunch. He's a great kid.
Okay. So, but on that level, like we also can't. We also can't deny the fact that, you know, say when we first did our demo that year, plenty funny music there out there. But now you also can't. You can't help but recognize the fact that all the youngins are, like, their music is proper. Their music is dope. You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
It may not be the most lyrical at most times, but
no. Then one by you. How did the Kinisi? They are the ones that have the numbers. You know, I want to know on the internet. They have the numbers. They have everything. So, and I think they also came with their sound as well. They have their sound right now.
Yeah.
You understand? They have their own unique sound. They are vibing to and they are collaborating a lot. You know, they are collaborating a lot.
Yeah.
I was going to mention that. And there are a couple of young cats. You know, that are doing stuff that I have been following, and I like what they're doing. The Cabex guy, is it Cabex or Cabex? He's a great storyteller. I like the kid. There's a kid called Bobby Philly. I don't know if you know him. There's a kid called Bobby Philly. That kid is a great kid.
Yeah.
That boy has been pushing for. I've known the kid about 2 years now. I think almost 2 years or so. 2 years. That kid has been pushing. There's no, you know, competition, no freestyle. Anybody puts out there, the kid is on it. He's pushing. So around September, October, I intend to put out like a rap EP with these kids I'm going to mention now. K-Bex, is it K-Bex or K-Bex? K-Bex.
Mm-hmm.
Bobby Philly. Then there's another one called Rook Castle. I don't know if you know him. I like him a lot. There's one kid called Rook Castle. There's one kid called Rook Castle. So these are the kids that have been looking out, you understand, that have been low-key. More observer, you know.
Cabex. I like it.
Is it called Cabex or Kibex?
Whichever one. When we sing one on one, he will tell us.
I like the key.
Yeah. Oh, like as we talk about Cabex, so I remember Hot Eyes. I remember Veda. I remember Pepa Coleon. People will be saying, because the goal also, whether you're about English, now say, if you keep it about the Kaimo,
of course,
right, you better be able to hold it down.
Yeah,
super. And shout outs to all these cats that are running it. I mean, at the end of the day, Sha. Me with rap crew beat, I just want to open them up to anybody who go run up. I just like for none, it doesn't that I've
been like, of course. Just you know, the idea is just nobody be Messiah now. You know, people have spent tens of millions of Naira people, but yeah, no matter story, no matter. But point is, nobody's just do your own beat, you understand, do your own beat to you know to put people on the spot and you know, have them help them exhibit their talent to the world and you know, just do your own beat and keep it moving. But yeah, do your own beat and keep it moving. But they're so tough one in Ogbe, but they're coming. You understand? So, you know, just mean, just, and a lot of it has to do with, just being honest with yourself, you understand? Wake up in the morning, tell yourself the truth. You understand? For example, I'll follow my story. I used to rap. I remember early days, Kabasa, Kone Tunes. You know, Kabasa would take me to OJB's, May Soul Rest in Perfect Peace, OJB Studio. You know, Kabasa would take me to OJB's place. I don't know if you remember these guys, Jafar and Abounce. You know, we'd see them there.
Abounce.
I'm a rap man. You understand? I'm a rap. Kabasa used to be really, really, really proud of me. And, you know, it didn't work out. I remember then I recorded my first album, I think 2003. And we wanted to have Rugged Man on it. It was trouble. We couldn't get Rugged Man on it. Later on, the Rugged Man said, I want to see Coded Tunes. quality, you know, work with knives and blah blah. You know, so I reminded him, I'm like, I wanted to feature you there, you know. And I tried this English thing out. So yeah, I tried this English thing out. It was dope. Kabasa was really proud. Kabasa would tell people this boy can rap, this boy can rap, you know.
Oh yeah, Isha Ogbera, he can rap, yeah, but Isha and I think it was Jaw Original. Anybody that listens to Jaw Original will hear me say, I usually don't do this. Because I've always believed that, you know, Yoruba rap was too easy for me. Like, to rap in Yoruba was easy stuff. You understand? Like, it was easy stuff. So, me, like my rap in Yoruba, I didn't like rapping in Yoruba. So, I'd be like, I'm okay, it's easy to. So, even if you listen to Jaw Original, I usually don't do this when I rap in Yoruba. Clever J, I had a collaboration with Clever J. It was called Friend or Foe. Mm-hmm. Was it, you know, almost a perfect mix of 8 bars English, 8 bars Yoruba. Fans again, people started Kini man. Then we did Jaw Remix. You understand? Mudu Tusi. Kini in Loke. My gay star Yoni, I got gay star Yo Fadi. Sounds called play beat and he said he had played the beat for NATO, but NATO didn't like it. Mugo boy, bang, 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 bang. Who you rappers? Abu Dhabi,
that's
right. So you got to like it. This is what you actually like. I can do this. Don't worry, you will keep collecting, you know. And ever since, and you know, then I told myself, look, there's nothing to be ashamed of, and I remember early days as well when there was a list of rappers then that came out. I think it was 2012 or 13, 2013 or so. There was a Not Just Okay list that came out then. And I think Not Just Okay put me at number 10. And there was number 10. Lali, number 10.
Number 10. Not Just Okay for me. Number 10.
Then people started questioning my, you know, my rap integrity. You know, people started questioning me. I swear, I don't want to mention names, or you know, a lot of OGs on TV started saying, yo, they understand. Of course, you've been fortunate from time now. You your name did there. So this is not my where they give me. You insist you not allow me. Take this number 10. You don't understand. Then people started, you know, saying, what is Reminisce doing on that list? There are a lot of people that are not supposed to be on. Then I remember there was a presenter, you know, on radio that, you know, this guy literally led the audience on. Because I'm like, okay, even if you want to do a poll, maybe poll, wrong way. Poll is the right word, yeah? Obeshe poll.
Fine.
Obeshe poll, fine. You get, you now go ahead and tell the audience, oh, there's a list of Not Just Okay, blah, 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 out. And people are saying Reminisce should not be on this list.
And Leto C, I remember it was myself and Leto C.
On that list, I remember. I'll tell you why I remember that. So I'm like, okay, no. I'm like, so you are leaving the audience on. Then people started calling in, chatting shit. I'm like, don't worry.
So that 2013.
I was like,
yeah,
I am going to do a proper rap album, which was Alaga Bile 1. I am going to make sure that any rapper that features me, I'm on my Jewon. They think my Jewon go, you're the draw. So that year, I think I did Mode 9, I did Neto C. That was why we did, that was the story behind Owuno the Touch. Yes, Owuno the Touch, my body with Neto C. So I did Mode 9, I did Neto C. I did too much remix with Zamani and Sauce Kid. I did Terry the Rap Man, you know, as well. So
what I'm saying, I mean, you guys fight. Now let me.
Are you not here to argue? Who's going to argue now?
You need to the boss, man. I swear, Google, all those listings, and for me, it's just always been okay. Kilefun, waiting at the take, analyze this thing. Because the last time I checked, for time, she did the same thing, but okay, go ahead, do what you need to do. But that period, it's funny, see, me and Sons just did studio, they make, speaking of Kitchen Street, I swear to Malam, it was just wordplay. I want to buy from Pound Lata, I need tomato. That was all that she was.
This is part of the disrespect. You people want to, you're using me to cash you. Okay, but if you beat me, download Cassidy for me. Download Cassidy for me. They're full boy. I remember that Sans was like, I don't want to be a part of this. Because now Sans almost produced the beat. But this guy said, Sans, I don't want to be part of this. Fuck off, dude. Fuck off. Download AM to the PM for me. You was crazy. You know that shit like under one hour. You made me send something. I'm like, which guy? See, I just ask. I say, if I don't want me with the go now. Say me with the go.
But you see the thing. You see, at the point there, I laugh. Say, where am I missing my family? When you ask, I share because longevity, long see. I swear.
Oh no. Then you know that period. I think you were doing activations for I can't remember the brand. Maybe Hennessy or something, yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh, man, it's activation, man.
When a lot of times when you came to the island as well, I'll get texts.
Yeah, you tell me. What's that place? Campus Square.
Yeah.
Because
man, no lie, the other day said we San Sultan they shoot video, and you're coming to play. Alaya, I go vector one, and I just drove past. Right.
Oh.
So anybody where the island, maybe say anything they saw, they go just Allah say. Guy, I find you. I'm like, okay, there's a waiting may happen. Waiting now may happen. Now, you know, pass that one now. Right. You feel me? Like, it's also with everybody mock with Koyito, Kajabi, Tikaku, Kona, Yoruba.
It was actually real. It was actually real.
Then a wife with the third person say, man, I calm down because everybody wants to be hard, some stupid hard that they're not. It's not cool to be hard. Mosquito is not a good, it's not a cool thing. Dirty water is not a cool thing. You understand? We thank God we come up for hood. Anyways. Bro, we have to return to our and we need our support for Afrobeat.
Afrobeat. We had discussed this earlier on and way back about a month ago, though. So, great movement, great. I think Young Six has something going on as well. Trap Pro. Young Six.
With him too, and the idea now is because. For me,
are we going to wait? Hold on, Larry, please. Hold on. So now, are we going to? Or is there going to be a unification bout, sort of? So rap four beat. Like, is there going to be a unification? We have any doubts in you? We have any meeting you? We have any discussion you? Is there going to be some sort of unification so that we have that one You know, because like I mentioned earlier, we are already a disadvantaged genre. You understand? So we cannot afford to, you understand, to show, you know, division here and there again and say trap pro, rap pro. So I think there needs to be like a uniform, you know, uniform term. See, people have to accept, you know, universally. Tademama beats, you know. So yeah. Tama, I can't forget.
The matter I say, I'm at young 60s or like, because I hear saying you do trap for a guy's Richard to him. However, in my own mind, if everybody knows this up now, like, this is rhyme.
Yeah.
Like, this on a rap pro beats, like, it is not a focus on trap music. It's a focus on African rap music. So, it's not African trap music. No, it's rap music in Africa, pretty much. But the foundation, the Afrobeat of Fela, because I don't think I know any musician that is more gangster than Fela in Africa. Nah,
never.
Uh-huh. So, which is also a dope foundation for the sternness that comes with rap. You get what I mean? Like, if they ask us, say, Kinikwele, share hardness, our reality, Fela is one of them musically, if not the greatest musically that was standing on that level. So for my head, I say, okay, rap as it is, as inspired by Fela, which is honesty, purity, and musical, not just one type of music, right? Just music in general. Naomi, I look at them as rap pro beats. But as we move together, we see how we unite. It's not to talk down another person's campaign, but I say, where me I go with my own. Now, it's not just on trap music, it's on rap music.
On rap music, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, you know rap the trap jadi. You know.
Well,
mm-hmm. You know rap the trap jadi.
Ram.
Oh, yeah. So yeah, all right. Sounds good.
Mm-hmm. So and our next record will be a feature on that level.
Our next record together.
Yeah.
You mean the one with me? You mean the one with me?
Yes, now.
Of course now. Fuji rap pro beat in Baggy Balapo.
Any beat that I can end with the rap.
I caught some intermediate. Oh yeah, Kiniko Lambert. When I'm selecting songs for my project, I'm like, okay, I tell my team, this one is minimum Lambert. Really, what intermediate to, you understand? You don't want too much of this on the project. To accept or else it will turn to a Lambert mixtape. You understand? You need to neutralize and
a bit of conscious music, a bit of a history, a bit of a history,
There's like four or five types of reminisce on every project. There's the singing reminisce, there's the rap reminisce that, you know, people like. There's the Lamba reminisce, you understand? Then you understand, Oishishi reminisce Romari, because I'm just what they want, because different people don't like reminisce, you understand? Different people like reminisce for different reasons. Some people don't even listen to my, some people, I have a close friend, one of my closest friends does not like any one of my up-tempo songs.
Mm-hmm.
Not one of them. Not one. Like it. If I tell him I'm putting out the joint, he's going to ask, is it my type shit or no? I say, sorry, shit, okay. Bye. Just say bye. You get like, he does not like my, yes, he yes. Just likes the, you know, the storytelling, the, you understand?
And there are people that like,
intermediate to 20 years. I want so you have to give those ones. You understand? You have to give those ones their thing. So you just should be able to find that balance. And you get just, I mean, as a creative, I mean, there's many. Miss your niche into the Everybody now in my estate, everywhere, people are chasing me for film. Please, have you done any other film?
Now those Nollywood shootouts, 90 my dear.
Calm down. So you know there are many sides that you know as a creative you know you want to satisfy because you don't want to meet any girls. Some people like I've never featured a girl before. You don't feature women. You don't sing with women. Your face is too strong. You don't sing love song. To them, it's a blues. I call blues for what you call. I call me live for. I call blues for enough. So you just satisfy. You know. Every part of, you know, that's part of being a creative now. You need to, and this is still, this still boils out to what we're talking about earlier. You understand? Passing this message across to the younger ones that look, rap, they're one side, you know, go for time, we need.
Of course.
There are still other parts that you need. You understand? You know, there's another audience out there that you need to cater to.
Or
you
understand? And make other parts that you are as well.
That you are. Which, of course, you can do.
If I'm doing rap pro beats, the best way is to tell you, I know Ice Cube, I know Dr. Dre, I know Jay-Z, I know Tupac, I know Nas, I know Ludacris, but I also know Adewale Ayuba. I know Prachi Mizie, I know Oliver Biko. If I just say I'm hungry for the dope, I'm all over with the coke, that should be fine. No, the thing you now say,
this me that you see here, this me, Emikini Buruku Timo Wawa Jwe, Timo Kono Kono Boy, Emile Mishiwai, our new generation kwa mwa lawa, Nino Ere Fuji. Ben, most of all,
Yes.
Beat me. You understand? So, and as you wish, you can't answer no. Only to catch. You know, it's like football now. It's only thing that is football. Music is not like football. You know, when we were younger, like when we were growing up, watching football, you had 4-4-2, the primary formation, Abi.
You had two strikers, Abi. You had out and out strikers.
Andy Cole, Arsenal player, for Arsenal. So Andy Cole, great job. Tore Andre Flo. But now you notice that forward in the ten, you see. Forward in the ten. You understand? Forward. You have Messi, Ronaldo. These boys do not. There's no because of the formation. Because if you don't back killer, the back man, back left, man, back right, only strike. So that versatility needs to be applied to music as well. So there's nothing called I'm a rapper. Because if you don't jab Momo Yanu, so yeah, the biggest rapper in the world is a great number list. Whether you like it or not, the biggest rapper is.
So Don Move as one of the biggest artists in the world is the number list. So don't show your matter. You have to learn to, you understand the inner lumbar list in you. The inner lumbar list in you, not denying it. But church, you sing church songs, you understand Muslim one you attack corny, only time yawakwa, you bad songs. You know these things, you can sing them, but you're ashamed because you think, oh, people are going to, you know, say you're not you dumped down or you're not a purist or my yard. You are in a panel, you are your cousins who listen. Yeah, you're talking. So, the earlier you wake up, the better. So that's for the younger ones. Now we are going to leave that. Of course, whiskey do have drink, but you're doing my essential. Ben, finish here.
What's in your instinct?
So that is that for the, you know, for the younger ones. A lot of you are doing good. God bless you. I appreciate you. I listen to a lot of you. I actually listen to a lot more. I listen to a lot of you. I listen to Bobby Phil. I listen to Newcastle. I listen to Beta. I listen to Black Bones, obviously. Talotuku, no, I know. Of course, I listen to Debuli. I like Debuli. I like Debuli. I like Debuli. I like all our dips. I listen to all our dips. Yeah. And what's that kid? K-Bex, the guy we talked about. Yeah. I just come up, see what's new out there. Just listen to them. Think about, you know, one or two things. You know, I can do to, you know, I mean, it's just one or two, no, everybody got shit here. Vector plays its part, Reminisce plays its part. I mean, your journey, turn of Masokwe, end of Kini and Yeh, Toba Beblu, fine. Turn of Masokwe, Konshou, man, you still have, you know, I mean, your journey continues, but it's not mandatory. You know, you all need to drop the entitlement. It's not mandatory, you know, that someone helps you or someone, you know, you need to put in work. Much if you Black Bones, all of you should look to Black Bones. Black Bones, I never just said to look at him and learn from him. He's a great kid. He's pushing himself. He's not dependent on anybody that's finding him to help him out. He's pushing himself. So learn from him. So Larry, that was the topic me. That was the topic me. But I just love Badi. I saw Lamba. I saw all.
It will look bad.
What did they watch in live?
No, now people got to know, say, all the men with their
life. What do I think about Devoli? Devoli is dope. The police dope. I listen to him. I listen to Festival, even before Festival EP. So someone is asking me what I think about the police EP. The police dope. I think he's dope. I like him. I listen to him. Yeah. It takes a lot for me to listen to, you know, someone that does what I do. So I listen to the police. Good. He's a dope kid. He's a dope kid.
I mean, the goal is to encourage everybody. And ultimately, as long as you're working hard, it doesn't depend on whether we did year with you the release.
Now,
When I met
Antonio, very correct. It doesn't change anything, and it also doesn't change anything. If I listen to you or not, no be me go make, no be me go blow you on Miami. Miami. If you gonna start with me come Bonnie, you know, I'm just talking about those I listen to. You know, those I listen to.
I want to touch on that one, making over, because a lot of youngins that you meet as well, they feel like it's the bragging rights that Reminisce listens to my shit. Oh, that's cool.
You know what I mean, but when I meet Larry, well, Larry, I like you alone, Larry, your husband is in the same way.
Do we not call him Speed Darlington?
I listen to Speed. Can we like Speed in your meaning?
Yeah,
Speed, I listen to Speed Darlington. Update Gidini.
He says his mind now. What is rap about?
I listen to his music and I listen to him himself.
But Shekino De Jerry, bro, he gets us plenty matter this up for the game. I just want everybody to understand that there is conversation and there is forward thinking with everything we do. Yeah, because finally now, the way they be now. They be like, say, Africa now, that's not, they protect itself against world news, power, fake news, real news, everything. Like, we feel like.
But I'm not saying, Larry, I think nothing working. Are we going to the woke side of the discussion now? If we are going to the woke side of the discussion.
I could think so, too. I'm not in a room. No, because the matter no pass like that. Now we need to make sure. See everybody understand. See everything we be to be Nigerian self they dope. Yes, Now we our Niro don't create. I want to share. Don't you get any go back? But you know now we you understand.
Yeah,
with our rap music, we can take over the world. We can make
music. Of course, we can
in the world. Yes, with our knowledge too, and still be dope. So the bottom line, because you play woke, but play. Even if you want to think about it on a woke level, what we are aiming at right now is beyond all of us just featuring each other or having each other up. It's like, there's greatness that Africa is that the world won't tell us.
Yeah.
We can tell ourselves.
We need to, I don't know, as a people, I think, fundamental flaws. I don't know, man. Like there's just something within us, you know, that just, you know, worships or admires that which isn't ours. You understand? You get what I'm saying? That you are just worships that likes to worship or admires that which isn't ours. You understand? Like, say, oh, Vector is dope now. I might tweet, keep, I might have, you know, been tweeting Vector is dope for 2 years, but nobody listens, as influential as I am. But once a Yankee artist that has half my following tweets it, it's valid.
Yeah.
You understand? I don't know if you get me. I might tweet Vector is dope, listen to Vector. You understand? Vector did this, Vector is the greatest. I might tweet it for 2 years, and some, you know, dude from Yankee that has half my following, you get. Now, when they tweet out, people believe, say, not true. You understand? So, there's that factor, you know, Niluwa, that I think we need to address. Like, you need to start, you know, respecting and, you know, pushing what is ours. Well, it's getting there bit by bit now. I think we started with the music already because, you know what it used to be like when we were younger now, like, OAPs didn't want to play Nigerian songs. You understand? They'll tell you, you know, there's limited time. You get, you remember now. So, talk less of Nigerian rap song. You get. So, we've taken it from that to this level right now where, you know, few Yankees, Emi Omi, Demoni, America, or Kobe, I don't know shit, bro. I'll be honest with you, me more shit. In fact, most of them go talk about off Tony Musham. I'm going, okay, oh, this person died. Oh, who's he? You know, like, oh, he signed it from. You know, so you get, so yeah, so you know, we've taken it from that point where they didn't used to play Nigerian music to right now, Nigerian music dominating airwaves. So I think we'll take the mentality will shift as well. You know, matter of time and of course a lot of reorientation and, you know, redirection from people like your very humble self, you know. Like, and you go to Gunta, you know, share.
And you're not a
better. And you're Gunta, you know, share. And
you know, you cannot remove yourself from this conversation. Not even joking.
Do I listen to Mondain? Of course, I have all Mondain's albums. I put it on the lyric. I put it on Telegraph. I had all Mondain's albums. I think it was 9 then. I think he had 9 projects then. I had every one of them. So, yes. I used to listen to a lot of Modena.
We like Manola, yeah. One of the first records of Modena, right? That the bomb blast, everybody move back.
Bro, Modena. It's about to get ugly. Modena, 6 foot.
Yes.
LD, triple extra large.
LD's verse on Tribesmen Records. I don't know. I never forget them.
LD's verse where?
There are no need to rush me. I will drop it now. Willing to make sure your
papa. LD the Don. LD the Don is, you know, is one of the few people I think people don't give enough credit for this business because LD really. LD try now, Vic. Yeah. LD try, bro. Oh yeah, LD try as pioneer from Alaba, from the Alaba model to, you know, to the tribe to bro. Oh yeah, LD tribe spearheaded, you know, Tribesman. And have you ever heard of Tribesman on your radio? Radio?
Maybe yes, maybe yes, maybe no.
JJ, I'm on Vic. Let's go. Where's JJ? I'm on Vic. JJ fucking influenced me, bro. I used to tune into Top 7. The first time my boy, Midas, may soul rest in perfect peace, played my song on Top 7, One Chance, 2003, I think. Was it 2003?
Yes.
No, 2008. 2008. I'm going to move that off. JJ, I'm a man. Let's go. Let's just go. Cut to visit to JJ. Like, bro, man. I'm going to shape. That man shaped a lot of, you know, shaped a lot of us. Like,
JJ, bro, when I did do that 2 hour freestyle plus for rhythm now,
bro, that man, a huge, huge, you know, custodian of the culture, man. Yeah. JJ put me onto a lot of rap songs. That time, no internet, no dream. You get internet, no dream. So now JJ was tuning to Jerry the Damager. Now JJ put me onto Jerry the Damager. Now he put me onto. What's this? This bros, wait, that passed, I think, 2 weeks ago. Where they jammed.
So rotted.
The people, this UK bros now. It was JJ. I remember him. It was JJ that put, like, JJ had a huge, you know, influence on, you know, my life, career. You know, I'm a man.
How do you come? I had a mistake waiting to talk for something else. You remember Kejo?
Kejo. Yeah, I remember him. Yeah, so, yeah, I remember. Not the Kejo at the top.
Who?
Not the Kejo at the top. You get one bros with the UK now. Ah, seen a black tie or black whatever. Have you? Ah, we sing Rotten. The song that Rotten, but you know, saying Jan. So rotten. That bros. That day they put me on. You understand?
It's crazy.
JJ, like ah, Paso Wambi, Alaji Wambi. Alaji Wambi.
Alaji earlier now.
Alaji, everybody say why? I want to tell anybody. I'm like, that's the guy.
I
want to have one. Let me do Mumbai, sorry. Hey, Galesa. Yeah, black man. Oh God.
I did bust my head. Like, guy, Nigerian rappers then be they drop bars, will be say, and they listen to Nigerian rap bars, and they force a year. Like, I never saw anybody in Nigeria.
Larry, all this one will be the D now. Lampani, oh, I'm going to rap more. We need more chances. We're going to toss it back. We're going to rap more. We're going to rap one or two. But yeah, we need to rap more. Bro, these people. Oh, I going to listen. You remember LD Triple X? You remember LD Triple X? I like. I'm reading.
Yes, now. I saw him last in Port Harcourt on radio.
Are you serious?
Yeah. Bros, no worry now. I listen.
Let's do something around. Oh, man, so many memories, bro. Come on.
Madness. Come on. We just have to build the value or build the connection between what is history for us and make sure because it'd be like sitting at the gap. Also, because rap was very, very competitive with us. And I say, you're not coming to my area, I'm not coming to your area, I'm not fucking with your clique, you're not fucking with my clique. But now we get plenty better mindsets to pass down, pass on, and also make sure people know who their historical rappers are.
You get
the guys that held it down, like JJ, the Mechadon, like
if
there was ever a Rev Ron.
JJ, then Oleg Boy, Ebotomashi Solid Jams, Star FM, what's his name? One man, DBN, Tele, used to be at DBN.
Shit.
Grandmaster Lee, PML, Grandmaster Lee. Grandmaster Lee.
I remember Djabdullah, Queen Change. Hey, what's this guy with the act? We do Channel 5 adverts. JT Tom West.
I love more. He passed.
Yeah, he did.
He's so rest the perfect piece. Yeah, he passed. Yeah, JT. Bro. Memories.
Yes, sir.
Memories.
We just
and right now, Razy Nikon, don't keep Kini going. Razy, you know, this has to be said. Razy is the only one, you know, repping the culture right now. You understand? Every other person, it's only when there's beef, when Vector is abusing Kini Kong, when I diss Vector. You understand? The others, it's only when I diss Vector now that you see them when it's trending topic, that means Vector, Kini Kong. That's when they start upping on hip hop. Start switching rubbish hip hop that they don't know about, history they don't know about. You understand? So this kid, Razy, is the only person supporting the culture right now. I'll be honest. Yeah.
Shout out to Razy, the rap culture.
And a couple of guys out there in Benin, I think. Morphine. You understand? I see them. Razy is apart from that, nobody does beef trending. That's when they start. You understand? That's when they last start topic. I start tweeting rubbish.
But bro, you understand? The work of commentator not to run commentator.
I saw something. One pocket and one. One pocket and raw.
They make that shit. They bust my head.
Raw pocket and raw.
MC is now who you be. Try to contest me, and then I grab the MIC. Then I go be.
No, that was blackface. That was blackface.
Yeah, that was blackface. I'm gonna touch your verse now.
Honey.
I'm gonna meet Ashiri Vass near now.
That's blackface. Blackface near.
Drunk
MCs now. Waiting day.
I'm only that Polite Kid Iro songs now. Forever.
No, everything they now with a Bopo play. But there's another song, Rap for Rocket and Ronnie. There's another popular rap song. Then Kilo Kwalaye. Anywhere where I go, tam 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 tam. Wait a minute, anywhere we go, anywhere we are go, like cinema, people always I know that the kind of profession that too. Can you what's the name?
I want Rooklyn, not that one.
I want bro.
Remember the hazardous? Oh,
Kilonso. Waiting day. I saw hazardous. Was it in England? I can't remember. I saw no. Ekoni. Show spin off. I saw hazardous. Yeah.
And speaking of people that are pushing music to Douglas, they give Douglas. They give a lot of shots to young kids. Maybe same side they discover talent for a show that's pushing good music till.
Who?
Douglas.
Douglas beat Abby. PGM, yeah, yes. Douglas, shout out to you, Douglas. I don't know if you're tuning in, shout out to you. You have invited me over a few times, but the problem with me is, Douglas, I don't like to talk in public because people don't like to listen to the truth. I mean, I don't like to. So, yeah, if you like him, I shut up. So, I do not want to be quoted. I don't want to end up on Insta blog. I don't want to be misquoted. So, yeah, shout out to you, Douglas. I see what you're doing for your PGM, following you, bro.
So, but somebody, no, we have to talk about at least one person.
About Gino. Who? About what?
Gino, I have a baby, Gino.
Ah, Gino. Gino, shape. Gino, I was fucking in here. Gino,
Don't worry.
Gino, no. No, Gino, I think when I was working on my fourth album with Sos, I swear, I'm sure if I dig my email, I'll find that song. I still do it. You wanted me to help us on the song there, but I don't know what just happened.
Okay, I swear to me, on this level, say real detail. I'll post about OG before I divorce. No more, we walk or disappear and sit by.
Same verse, missing me now. I'll now.
But later, don't be changing your number. I'll change your number.
Oh, right. But if I don't bear my jam, whatever I want to be low.
It's long overdue for everybody to understand. Yeah. Say, mean for go more based on say where everything they go, Alaye, Parakpo, all this shit.
But we need to come together and try and do great stuff rather than this. I'm goat. You are goat. You are Omoyami. Do nobody is any good anyway. Babani, nobody is good because if you are going to say you are the goat, if you are measured by another, if you say you are a goat with lyrics, you will not be a goat with numbers. If you are a goat with numbers, you will not be a goat with heat. If you are a goat with understand. So I mean, we just need to just realize many goats, they respect each other and move on. You understand? Everybody has numbers in their world, and the award and these are. So everybody is a goat. I'm a goat in my house now. I'm the greatest rapper in my house.
with the game.
So, I mean, we as, especially we, I say, I don't know if it's the right word, better hands, we need to do better, just come together and, collaborate more. Collaboration doesn't have to be, musical and all that, but, we need to do. Shout out to you, please. Just put out his 10th project. No be beans, no be young man. Always rapping for the culture. Deserves way more respect, than it's getting right now. I'd like to add that. Yeah. Shout out to you, please. I think we all need to come together and do, because like I said, a lot of us are closer to 40 than we are to 30, so we need to start doing meaningful stuff right now and leave all that good conversation and greatest conversation and where else it will go off key. If you are good, let me say this openly, anybody can see go see goat anywhere, any fucking year. There's no goat anywhere. If you say you are good You are good to your followers. So my followers are goats. Trust me. Anybody's followers can go through this. Vector's followers think he's the goat. You understand? So how you want to measure it depends on, of course, people like to measure stuff the way it favors them, you know, the way it favors them. When they are trying to sell a separate narrative, they'll say, oh, Omo Yami, if you measure it by my own, so yeah, you are not good. You are not foul.
Jacob, we end our life on one thing. Kokoton Shelley, I've been seeing, and I feel like a lot of young people watch what we do and they listen to what we say. And there's this madness about, it's not just about the idea of rape, because nobody today now would already say people they rape. So what was bad then is bad now. But there is a mentality that we see. There's a mentality that we see with people just thinking, ah, it's okay, it's just be whatever you want to be about the conversation. They feel me. Like, yeah, they make them be like, say, you know, be serious thing enough for us to stop. Especially since, say, nobody go pray, make it happen to your own female, anything. Whether female, whether sister, whether sibling, all those kinds of things. So I feel like it would be nice for us to also address how what a disgusting thing it is. You know,
yeah.
Like, small.
Yes, it is. It is. First off, I'd like to start with, of course, I have three daughters. You understand? So you should understand that this is naturally, you know, a sensitive topic or you understand situation for me. Because I don't want to imagine, you know, that stuff happens to any of my kids. You get? Mm-hmm. So I tell you, part of being game, no ni pe oye. To my mom, oh, you're going to cajole now. You understand? You should be able to cajole. There's enough time to cajole. If it doesn't work today, I work tomorrow. You keep, you understand? But when someone says, no, I don't want this, you respect them and keep it moving, bro. But yeah, you let it go. You keep it moving. You understand? It's disgusting. It's not fair. It's not kind. It's not nice. So you understand? You keep it moving. Like, normal, kinini. But yeah, when I go, you're not going to go to the water. When I go back, yes. But yeah, we don't have to call your name console. I want your call go on my way. Continue, Danny.
Yeah.
So yeah, I want to call more. We are culture. Yeah. Don't be mad. No, we are shaking the city. You understand that culture? Everyone less. So people need to be, you know, only that the one new orientation that, you know, no means no. Tom, I never know who she. On to the next one.
Yeah.
Go and rebrush your lyrics. Go and rebrush your lyrics and reshoot. You understand somewhere else. You understand? So yeah, But you know, there's no fun in forcing people, raping and, you know, assaulting people and all that. And mostly going to actually find out the play you rape will go back to assault gong gong for I'm not understanding. Vector, why did you go to lunch, Jenny?
No, chicken, Moje.
You understand? So I'm saying this very, very loud and clear. You know, no means no. Seek consent. And as it applies right now, only in between God, take consent about withdrawal of Miami. Could that do you? You understand?
Not just me.
Oh, yes. Oh, hello. Good to see you. Come on, Yami, so that you don't end up in trouble, in pepper. You understand? So, and tell your friends, tell your whoever you need to, you know, enlighten as well or inform as well. It be no means no. Come on, let me know what you're going to say. Go to go advance. Yeah, advance.
Yes, sir. Mm. Remy, I appreciate you, Jerry. He makes sense.
Yeah, my bro. My bro. You want to go on the one, but I want to get it. I'll get it.
Yes. I greet you, bros. So, bass me.
Yeah. I'll record. Today's Tuesday, by Friday, my Sunday. Maui, my Sunday, Friday.
Okay.
Motive record, I'm missing my worry. I'm recording myself. I'm a great engineer. Don't worry. I'm a great engineer. Don't worry.
You know. Yeah, blessings, I appreciate you.
All right, my G. Regards to the fam, man. Bless up.
Yes, sir. You too. Yeah. Anyways, thanks for tuning in, guys. It was a wonderful session. I mean, once in a while we do what we do to sanitize our minds, because we don't sanitize our hand really now, so most cities sanitize our minds. And yeah, when let the women be, you know, some people say mistake they happen, but make sure saying a mistake they happen. Feel me? Make sure that if it's a mistake, it's a mistake. You get what I mean? You get what I mean? And if you know saying a mistake before, you want to make sure saying a mistake. You suppose they know saying mistake and a bad thing. But bless up, guys. We are later.